If you've never heard of transthyretin amyloid cardiomyopathy, also called ATTR-CM, you're not alone. It's a rare progressive disease that affects the heart. Walt shares his story today to raise awareness about this condition.
In 2010, I went to the emergency room because I was having difficulty breathing. I was told for the second time that I have congestive heart failure. Then in 2015, my breathing problems recurred. 3 years later, my doctors finally learned why I have heart failure. An echocardiogram suggested amyloid deposits in my heart. Genetic testing indicated that I have wild-type ATTR-CM, which I learned is a rare heart condition. I spent nearly 11 years trying to get the proper diagnosis. I hope that by sharing my experience, I can help others understand the importance of early diagnosis and treatment.
Dr. Frieda Lewis-Hall, the chief patient officer of Pfizer, is back to discuss this potentially fatal disease. And Dr. Frieda, can you explain why this happens and what people need to know?
Yeah, so this disease is caused by an abnormal buildup of an abnormal protein in organs and in nerves. Now, when this happens in the heart, it causes the heart muscle to stiffen. When that happens, the heart's ability or efficiency at pumping blood to the rest of the body is decreased, and that leads to heart failure.
Unfortunately, ATTR-CM is often misdiagnosed or can go undetected because of the different and subtle ways it may present. It can also be easily confused for other conditions, and by the time it is diagnosed, a patient may be at an advanced stage, which is never a good thing.
No, and if you're diagnosed with heart failure and you don't actually know the cause, it can mean that you're not getting the right treatment. Now, there are several ways that you can confirm the diagnosis of this disease. Tissue biopsies, genetic testing, and there's some new technology of imaging scans.
Now, keep in mind that the symptoms of ATTR-CM can be similar to those of heart failure. They may include shortness of breath, especially with minimal exertion or when lying down, coughing or wheezing, swelling in the feet, ankles, and legs, bloating in the abdomen, increased heart rate, or abnormal heart rhythms. You may also experience carpal tunnel syndrome, as well as numbness and tingling in the hands and feet.
You know, and if someone's sitting there saying, okay, how would I know if I or someone that I loved was at risk for this rare disease? I want to tell you that there are two types. So the first type, you inherit from your parents. And in the U.S., this is more common in people of African-American and Afro-Caribbean descent. This is called the hereditary type.
Okay.
Now, the second type does not run in families. This is more common in males over the age of 60. And this is the type that Walt has, and you heard him refer to it as the wild type.
Keep in mind that this disease affects people differently, and that's why it's so important to know your family history and to talk to your doctor if you notice any symptoms.
Absolutely, and there's lots to know about this. So you can always go to gethealthystayhealthy.com, and while you're there, you can sign up for our monthly newsletter.
Dr. Frieda, always a pleasure. Thanks so much for being
My
here
pleasure.
And talking about this important topic. Certainly want to thank Walt also for sharing his story. The best to you, Walt. Please stay tuned. We'll be right back.